I already heard that the electricity, the prices are getting more expensive in Europe. Is it right?
That's absolutely true. That's why I came to Taiwan.
A German guy
sees the solar panel the first time in his life. It is. Thank you.
大家太热情了吧。Hello， 朋友们，欢迎来到我的频道。马上介绍给你们来自德国的帅哥 Alex。
Hi guys, hi.
Have you ever been to Jai before?
I have been to visit friends,some nature. Alishan is here. I know the chicken rice is famous as well.
Yes, right? Good. But today our mission is different because you are coming from Germany, one of the most developed countries in solar power. And today I want to show you a different side of Taiwan, how we produce.Energy by using solar panels. Have you seen any solar farm before?
Never yet in life.
But Germany is very developed with the solar farms. I thought that maybe everywhere you can see it.
Yeah, they are, absolutely, yeah, for sure. We have right now around 10% of solar energy.
What about your city?
I am from Bielefeld, but I live in Köln.
Also, there are many solar farms, I guess, in the near part of your city.
That's a good question. But the most important thing is that we find land to build them first. So the government needs to give us a permit.
It's actually the same in Taiwan. You see, on the left side, this is one of the biggest solar farms of Taiwan.
Wow, that's huge.
I'm going to introduce you the manager of this place.我相信，你们在这里生产是蛮多电量，你知道大概多少吗？
这边其实有80公顷，
80公顷，
对，80公顷那么大。那一年的一个大概电量的大概会在1亿度电，发1亿度电。
1亿度？I don't know what is like 1亿度。I know what is it too much or 是很多吗？还是很少吗？
有点难想象，对不对？其实我们台电呢，就是有做过调查，我们大概一户人家一年的用电量将近4000度，所以呢，代表说这里的一年的电量可以供这一户人家使用24000年。
哇！一个家庭就是一户，
而
24000年。
Here we have an original solar panel, right?
Yeah.
I have two questions. One question is, how do you clean it? And the second one is, how do you recycle them?
Yeah, okay, sure. Before I answer, you could touch the panel first. Feel. Feel the panel.
For the first time, I touch a solar panel. Yeah.
Very smooth.
Yeah.
对，那这一个太阳能板跟刚就是在外面看到的太阳能板是一模一样的。对，那其实太阳能板的组成呢，其实很简单，它就有分就是6个部件。对，那大部分的一个组成是由玻璃组成，因为玻璃就很像我们在前面开车的挡风玻璃，大部分的脏污会是灰尘，对，所以其实用我们一般的 clean water 就冲一冲，它其实就会干净了。
你是说我们在家里用的那种？
浇花的
呀，就是我洗澡的
呀呀呀，洗澡用的 clean water，
就是
冲一冲就可以。那我们大部分的暗场都是这样子去洗我们的 panel， 对，而且我们不能使用清洁剂，因为我们都还会有生态的保育的问题，对，所以都要毕竟一定要用干净的水。那关于回收问题呢，我们想要先问你们一个问题，我们是不是都有身份证 ID card？
Yes.
Of course I have.
Yeah, yeah.
You have?
Everyone have, right?
I have two.
You have two ID?
Okay. One from Taiwan, one from Turkey.
Wow.
Turkey.
You know the solar panel also have?
I didn't know that.
太阳能板也有。
真的吗？
You can find it first. Yeah, it's a label.
一个 number.
Yeah, it's a number. 对，就是那边。这个 ID 非常的神奇哦，它是可以去追踪的 ID 是，比如说是哪一个暗场拥有，甚至是它的制造商，它所有的资讯都在这一个 ID 里面。所以到时候20至25年后，它要回收的时候，它只要 scan 这个 ID， 它就可以知道所有的一个资讯，那就有它的一个回收的机制跟方法。
阿林，你提到这个地方是80公顷哦，
对，
蛮大的一块地。然后呢，听说20-30年呢，这个地方是空空的嘛。那好奇的是，你们确定这个建设 solar farm 的时候，经过哪些过程呢？
建这个 solar farm 的开发初期，我们就已经有与地方的 local， 就是居民，然后政府，甚至是环保团体，因为刚刚有提到这边20-30年没有用，对不对？所以会有很多的就是野鸟会来使用这一块土地，对。所以经过多方的沟通，甚至我们在开发的时候就已经有做水质。 跟底栖生物鱼虾、哦、对、okay. 这一些的调查，那公开这一些资讯让大家来做了解。施工时我们也尽量避开十一月到隔年三月的期间，为什么呢？
这为什么？
因为有冬候鸟。台湾其实是、哦、对，你知道黑面琵鹭吗？对、
oh, 对，看这一些就是他们
就叫冬候鸟，那他们就会来这边栖息，所以我们尽量避免这一个期间。
Okay.
对，那其实整个就是建设完之后，我们经营其实已经四年了。对，那在这四年中间，我们也与高雄鸳鸟学会跟东海大学，他们会来帮我们做一些水质、鱼类，那甚至是野鸟的观察。就是在建设初期呢，我们其实就是要兼顾这边的生态，所以我们有保留30%，就是让这一些野鸟可以一样可以过来这边栖息，然后做使用。而且每个月甚至每季，我们都会定期的开会来检讨说，这个栖地的一个环境啊，是不是鸟类有喜欢，是不是哪里需要调整、嗯、这一些的。对，那这一些的资讯也都会在我们的网站来做一个公开。
But there is another system in Taiwan.I want to bring you that very famous spot, Xiqu, Xi District.
Okay.
At that place, there is a community and they have apartments by using the roof, the rooftop. Because the solar farm is on the roof.
Okay, cool.
In Chinese language, we call it Sunjian Yidong. You know what is the meaning of it?
No.
It means in 1 second, you go from this place to another place. Are you ready?
Okay.
1, 2,
Let's
three, go.
go.
So this is Sunjian Yidong. Now I want to show you the roof style of solar farm. Can you see it?
No.
This is...
Okay.
You see, this one is the rooftop. Actually, this is a roof, right?
Okay.
And we have another place. This is for the solar panels. This place, the community has the Taiwan's oldest and the biggest roof style of solar farm. For more information, I want to introduce you, 我们的总干事。总干事好。
好。
你好。
你好，吴凤好。
你们到底当时啊，怎么做到这样子的一个系统啊，固定型的发电的方式？
是我们大概是四五年前了，开始那个组委接触到这种太阳能光电的知识，他就。致力于推动在屋顶上盖这个太阳能板。
I have another question. Did they have any troubles or struggle while building this one?
刚开始有很多住户也是反对，认为会花太多的钱啊，或者会造成怎么样不必要的干扰，比如说有辐射啊，有什么。那后来参观完工厂，也看过实际操作以后，才发觉这所谓的辐射频率的干扰，这些比手机的干扰都还要小，所以住户就能够接受了。没有什么坏处，而又有这么多好处。第一个，每年省掉修漏水的100多万，而且漏水还是每年都要修，永远修不好。啊，第二个，卖电给台电，我们就增加每年100万的收入，帮社区赚钱。这个钱也是当作福利金发给各位住户。啊，再来，再一个就是夏天。又可以降低温度，大概顶楼比有装跟没有装以前温度差的4-5度，那这个省下来的冷气的费用就相当的可观。
How was the feeling of the solar farms?
Very interesting. It's the first time, like I said, I see this kind of huge solar plant. It's very, very special experience.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Actually, today we saw two types of solar farm. One is the flat area solar farm. We called it.地面型的，另外也是 the other one is rooftop, it's the 屋顶型的发电 solar farm.、Mm-hmm. 但是呢，在台湾呢，高雄还有一个是阿公水库，在那个地方呢，他们用的是水上面，因为水上面他们放了那些solar panels 之后呢，他们还是可以用得到太阳能可以来发电的。I know in Germany also you have the reservoir systems, right?
Exactly, we also have reservoirs. The good thing is it's environment friendly, it's not non-toxic because of the silicon, and we use it quite much actually.
This is already for the world is a trend. Green energy and also reducing the carbon, we have to do it. We can't say that I don't want it. We have to make it, especially in European Union, you have very strict regulations, as I know.
Exactly. European Union announced the CBAM right now, which is actually specifying the carbon content for exporting goods. And we started the trial already 2023 in October.
130个国家已经宣布了，他们说2050年的时候把碳排放量变成零。Germany, Turkey, Taiwan, 加油！
加油！
Thank you. You came to my video.
Thank you for
inviting. Became our guest.
Thank you very much.
And I hope more friends, more Taiwanese friends, more foreign friends watch this video and share with your all relatives, with all your friends all around the world. 希望更多人看这个影片，让更多人了解一下什么是太阳能，什么是green energy。然后呢，德国怎么做，土耳其怎么做，台湾怎么做？记得订阅，我们下次见。拜拜，朋友们！
拜拜
！Auf Wiedersehen！
Auf Wiedersehen！
终于可以讲一点点德文了哦 ，Danke schön！